Yo, what's going on guys, Tanmay for Simple Snippets, back with another video tutorial on C++ programming, especially the object-oriented programming. So today's topic is going to be multiple inheritance and a special case which creates an ambiguity in the program. So we've already seen what inheritance is and we've discussed that extensively in this entire video tutorial series. So if you're new on this channel, you can check that video. On the top right corner, you can see a card, you can check that video and make sure you subscribe to this channel because you'll get notified whenever I upload a new IT video tutorial. So with that being said, let's get started. Okay, so multiple inheritance is a feature of C++ where a class can inherit from more than one class. So you can see in the diagram, we have base class 1 and base class 2 and the properties from both the classes are being inherited in the derived class. So this is a special type of inheritance because there arises a different or a scenario where there is a confusion in the program running and we'll actually address that in the program itself because that's the best way I can show you what the problem is. So this was just about a theory and what multiple inheritance looks like. Now let's dive in the programming part. So quickly open up your DAC++ IDE and let's start off by creating a basic class. So I'll say class A. Inside that class in the public section, I'll say void print message. So I'm just creating a basic function inside the public part of class A and inside that I'll say cout class A print message function. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create one more class, class B. Again, just copy this entire public part and paste it over here and inside this just change the class A to class B. Okay, so this is going to be the base class 1. So base class 1. This class B is going to be base class 2 and now I'm going to create one more class. So I'll say class AB, which is going to publicly inherit class A and class B. So I'll say public A comma public B. So this is how you perform multiple inheritance. You write down the first class, then you put a comma and you write down the second class. Now notice that A is in caps because it is case sensitive. So if it would have been small a, then I could have written over here small a. But since it is capital A, I have to use capital A itself and it does make a difference. So it will give you an error if you write down small a. Okay, so our new class AB is inheriting from A and B as well. So in this case, let's see what exactly class AB is inheriting. Now A has a public method, which is void print message, and even B has a print message. So here's where the actual ambiguity or confusion arises as to which method exactly is being inherited in AB. Essentially what is happening is both these messages, that is both these functions, void print message from class A and void print message from class B, both are inherited in AB. So if in the public section, if I override this message, if I say there is one more print message inside our derived class AB and I say class AB, in that case if I create an object of this derived class, so I'll say AB obj and if I say obj dot print message, in that case this line would be printed, that is class AB print message function, because we know function overriding and we've already extensively talked about function overriding. So if you don't know what it is, you can see a card on the top right corner which points to that video. But in function overriding, the derived class function overrides the base class functions, and since the function is same, the derived class function will be called in this case. But what if we don't have this function in class AB? So in that case, this function from the base class 1 and this void print message from base class 2 both will come into our derived class AB. So just to actually demonstrate you, let's first save this and let's try to run this. Let's see which message is printed. Right now we have overridden the print message, so class AB print message function should be printed. So let's go ahead and execute this, compile and run. So there you go, you can see class AB print message function, which means that this function was called because we performed function overriding. So let me just remove this from class AB, which is our derived class, and let's just keep this as it is. In fact, let's just remove this also. So now, because we are not creating our own print message in the derived class AB, print message from class A is also coming and print message from class B is also coming in this AB class. So how do we actually test this out? So now let's try to create AB object. So I've created an object of this derived class AB. So this is our derived class and let's try to print message. Now, since this object has two different copies, one is from class A and one is from class B, so it should throw an ambiguity error, which means it will say that it doesn't know which print message exactly are we referring to. So let's save this and let's try to execute this, and it should give us an error. So as you can see, it is throwing an error over here on this line 33, and in the error you can see request for member print message is ambiguous. So candidates are void B colon colon print message, void A colon colon print message, which means that there are two options, but the program doesn't know which print message are we referring to. So this is the ambiguity problem in multiple inheritance, which arises when we have same functions being inherited in the derived class from the two or more than two different base classes. So there could have been one more base class which would have same message, and if we have added one more in the multiple inheritance, even that would come in this derived class. So how do we basically solve this problem? So the way we solve this problem is we first have the public section, and inside that we create that print message. But inside that, say for example you want to call print message only from class A, so what we do is we write down the class name A, and then we use the scope resolution operator, which is 2 times colon, and then you can see in the IntelliSense the message pops up, and you can see print message is available over here. Just double click on it, semicolon, try to save this, and now this print message from class A will be called. So go to compile and run, and there you go, we did not get any error of ambiguity, we got directly the message that is class A print message function. Similarly, if you want class B print message to be printed, just replace this with B, or you can also have both of them, so just do it 2 times, just replace it with class A, save this, execute, compile and run. You can see both the message will be printed. You can see class A print message, class B print message, and after that you can also have your own cout class AB print message, because essentially we are again overriding the print message function. Save this, compile and run. Okay, I forgot to add one symbol and semicolon. Save this, compile and run, and you can see now the third message is also printed. So yeah, this was about multiple inheritance and the special case where the ambiguity occurs, and you can use the scope resolution operator to resolve this ambiguity, and you can particularly call one function from the different base classes which you actually want to call. So yeah, that's it for this video guys. I hope you understood the special case of ambiguity in the multiple inheritance, and you know how to perform multiple inheritance in the safe way. So yeah, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and make sure you subscribe to this channel. Peace.